Dear students, good morning. Today we are going to start chapter 2 of geography, that is land, soil, water, natural vegetation and wildlife resources. The chapter begins with the story of two children, Mamba and Peter, living in different parts of the world. Through this story, we come to know that in different parts of the world, people live differently because there is difference in quality of soil, land, availability of water, natural resources, and uses of technology. Broadly, Earth can be divided into two parts, that is land and water. Nearly 30% area of Earth is land. Distribution of population is highly uneven due to land and climate, rugged topography, mountain slopes, deserts. Areas of thick forests are thinly populated. Such kind of areas support less number of people. On the other hand, fertile plains, river valleys are thickly populated. Land is put under various uses, which is known as land use pattern of an area. We make use of land for agriculture, forestry, mining, building houses, infrastructure, roads, setting up industry, and grazing animals, etc. India has maximum land under agriculture. No other country in the world has 46% area under agriculture, but we have. Nearly 23% of our land is under forest. To maintain ecological balance, it should be 33%. The areas which are rich in minerals, such as Peninsular Plateau, the main occupation of people here is mining. 10 to 14% land is given to building houses, roads, industries, infrastructure, railway, etc. 3 to 4% land is given to pastures for grazing animal. India has largest number of cattle, and in comparison to that, land under pasture is quite low. The factors which affect land use pattern of an area can be categorized as physical factors and human factors. Physical factors comprises topography, soil, climate, minerals, and availability of water. On the other hand, human factors include population and technology. With the help of pie diagram, this is land use pattern of first figure 1960s and second 2010. It has shown with different colors that some part of land is under agriculture, some under forest, fallow land, cultivable wasteland, barren land. Land use pattern is shown. And there is some difference. For example, land under forest has increased in past 50 years. Despite of increasing population, land under forest has increased, which is a satisfying feature. And reason behind that is awareness. Now people are aware about importance of forests. We can classify land on the basis of ownership into two parts: private land, which is owned by individuals. Second, community land, owned by community for common uses like collection of fodder, fruits, herbs in villages and in cities. Parks are example of common land. It is also known as common property resource. Increase in population led to more demand of food grains, so people started encroaching the common land to bring more and more land under cultivation and to increase the agricultural production. Quality of land also varies from place to place. Some areas have fertile soil, on the other hand, few areas have shallow soil. Expansion of agriculture and construction activities are two human activities which led to land degradation. landslides, soil erosion, desertification. Land degradation means when land becomes infertile and unfit for cultivation. Landslide, mass movement of debris down the slope. Soil erosion, wearing away of the topmost layer of the earth. Desertification refers to expansion of desert. This is the picture showing soil degradation. Such kind of land is not fit for agriculture. There are few factors which are responsible for land degradation. Deforestation, overgrazing, overuse of chemical fertilizers, climate change, over-irrigation, shifting agriculture, and mining. Conservation of land resource. How we can conserve land? Afforestation, land reclamation, regulated use of chemical pesticides, fertilizers, check overgrazing, and restrict mining activities. These are few ways how we can conserve land resource. Landslides. Mass movement of rock, debris, or earth down a slope is called landslide. The areas which are made up of unconsolidated rocks, such as Shivalik Hills, are more prone to landslides. How can we prevent landslide? First, identify areas which are prone to landslide, and we should avoid construction activity in those areas. We are making roads in hilly areas which led to landslide. We should plant more and more trees and increase vegetation cover in these areas. Make retention wall to stop land from slipping. These are few ways to check landslides. Here is the picture showing landslide. Let's discuss one more natural resource, that is soil. The uppermost layer of the earth's surface which support natural vegetation is referred as soil. It is thin layer of grainy substance covering earth's surface. It is made up of organic matter, means remnants of plants and animals, which is known as humus, and they add fertility to the soil. Minerals and weathered rock. Soil is formed by breaking up of rocks. Proper mixture of organic matter and minerals make soil fertile. Soil formation is a very slow process. It takes 82,000 years to form 1 centimeter layer of the soil. Here it is shown soil profile. We can divide soil profile into 3 categories. A, horizon, which refers to topsoil. B, horizon, subsoil. And C, horizon, parent rock. Factors which are responsible for soil formation. Nature of parent rock, relief, climate, flora, fauna, and microorganism, and time are few factors which are responsible for soil formation. Degradation of soil. When soil loses its fertility and become infertile, then it is referred as soil degradation. You have already read in previous slide causes of land degradation or soil degradation, more or less they are similar. Soil erosion, deforestation, overgrazing, landslides, floods, and overuse of chemicals and fertilizers. Now, when we have discussed the problem of soil degradation, let's talk about remedies, how we can save, protect, or preserve soil from erosion. There are few methods such as mulching, contour barriers, rock dam, terrace farming, intercropping, contour plugging, shelter belts, and afforestation are few ways to check soil erosion. What is soil conservation? This is the definition. Soil is a non-renewable natural resource that is necessary for plant growth. We must conserve our soil because all our needs are fulfilled directly or indirectly from the soil. And moreover, soil formation is a very, very slow process. Soil conservation is a method to maintain the fertility of soil by protecting the soil from erosion and loss of nutrients. Thank you. Water is most important natural resource as it is essential for survival of all the living organism on the surface of Earth. Earth is called a watery planet because out of 8 planets, only Earth has water. It is also known as blue planet because we represent water with blue color. 3/4 of the Earth is covered by water, but still there is water scarcity in some parts of the world because 96.5% water which is present on Earth's surface is saline. It is not of use for industries, agriculture, or for drinking purpose. 2.5% is in form of ice sheets and glaciers. Only 1% is fresh water, that is rain water. Life began in water about 3.5 billion years ago. Water is most important renewable. The movement of water between hydrosphere, atmosphere, and lithosphere is known as water cycle. Through evaporation, ocean water reaches to atmosphere. There, condensation takes place. After condensation, precipitation, and water reaches to the lithosphere again in form of rainfall and reaches to sea through lakes, rivers, etc. It is in constant motion, cycling through the oceans, the air, the land, and back again through the process of evaporation, condensation, precipitation, and runoff. We use water for these purposes. First, domestic purpose like drinking, bathing, washing, cleaning, etc. Agriculture. Maximum part of water is used for irrigation. India is an agricultural country and second most populous country of the world. So to grow more crops, we need timely water to the crops, which is provided through irrigation. Industries. Industries make use of water for cooling, washing, mixing, etc. By constructing dam across rivers, we generate hydroelectricity, which is neat and clean source of energy. Water scarcity. Shortage of water in comparison to its demand is referred as water scarcity. There are few causes of water scarcity. For example, increasing population, rising demand of food and cash crops, urbanization, modernization, industrialization, and pollution. These are few factors which are responsible for water scarcity. Causes of water pollution: industrial effluents. Industries such as tanneries, dye house, chemical industry, they drain their hot and untreated water into rivers. Domestic waste, sewage waste also add pollution to water. Discharge of untreated waste, use of pesticides, chemical, weedicide, fertilizers, and some religious activity are responsible for water pollution. Water conservation. Fresh water is most important substance on the surface of Earth, and we have seen in the previous slide that only 1% fresh water is available on the surface of Earth, and it is essential for survival of all the human beings, plants, and other living organisms. Water is a renewable resource, but its overuse and pollution make it scarce and unfit for use. we should take steps to conserve it. Let's see what steps we can take. Treating effluents before releasing them into river, afforestation, water harvesting, modern methods of irrigation, and by spreading awareness. Rainwater harvesting. It is the process of collecting rainwater from rooftops and directing it to an appropriate location where it is stored for the future use. Rooftops are used for collection of rainwater through PVC pipe. The water is sent to a dug well. In our school, we are having two rainwater harvesting systems. One spell of rain for 2 hours is enough to save 8,000 liters of water. Tankas in Rajasthan, Gul schools in Himalayas, Johars in villages, Khadin in Jaisalmer, Check Dam are some ways to store rainwater. Now, let's move to last part of the chapter, that is natural vegetation and wildlife. They exist in a narrow zone of contact between land, air and water, which is known as biosphere. All the living beings are interrelated and interdependent on each other and on the physical environment in which they live for their survival. This life supporting system is referred as ecosystem. What are the uses of forest? They provide us timber, fuel, fodder. They provide habitat or shelter to animals, produce oxygen we breathe, protect soil from erosion, acts as a shelter belt, help in bringing rainfall, provide food, medicine, lac, paper, and number of products we get from forests. How wildlife is important? Wildlife includes animals, birds, insects, as well as the aquatic life form. When we talk about aquatic, it means animals which live in water. They provide us milk, meat, hide and skin, wool. Insects like bees provide us honey. Birds and insects help in pollination of flowers. They act as decomposers. Birds eat insects. Vulture is cleanser of environment. It is eco-friendly bird as it eat the flesh of dead animals and help in cleaning the environment. It also help in maintaining ecosystem. If we talk about any small creature like ant or earthworm, all have their own role to play in the maintenance of ecosystem. Distribution of natural vegetation on the earth is dependent on two basic factors, which are temperature and rainfall. Major type of natural vegetation found in the world are forests, grasslands, scrubs, tundra. Grasslands you have read in standard 7th, tropical and temperate grassland found in all the continents but known by different name. Tundra is type of vegetation where only mosses and lichens are found. These areas are snow covered and temperatures are below 0 degrees Celsius. Scrubs, thorny bushes, shrubs are found in these areas, and forests can be categorized in 5 parts, but in your book only 2 types are given. One is evergreen and second is deciduous. Let's break the word evergreen in 2 parts. Ever means always and green is a color. The forests which appear green throughout the year are referred as evergreen forest. It doesn't mean they do not shed their leaves. They do shed their leaves, but there is not a particular season. Ebony, mahogany, rubber are few examples of evergreen trees. Deciduous forests. These forests shed their leaves in a particular season, that is early dry summer season. and duration is for 6 to 8 weeks. It means deciduous forest shed their leaves during early dry summer season for 6 to 8 weeks to conserve loss of moisture through transpiration. Transpiration means loss of water from plant leaves. Teak, sal, shisham, neem are few examples of deciduous forests. These are of great commercial value, and these forests are also known as monsoon forests. There are some threats to natural vegetation and wildlife. Many species have become vulnerable or endangered, and some of them are on verge of extinction due to following reasons: deforestation, soil erosion, constructional activities, forest fires, tsunamis, landslides, poaching and smuggling. Poaching means illegal hunting. Smuggling means when we trade in bones and parts of animal illegally. Hunting, etc., are few threats to natural vegetation and wildlife. What steps have been taken by the government or people to conserve natural vegetation and wildlife? National parks, wildlife sanctuary, biosphere reserve. In our country, there are 92 national parks, 490 wildlife sanctuaries, and 14 biosphere reserves. Keep in mind, the main objective of these three is to protect and preserve wildlife. Awareness programs, making laws. In 1972, Wildlife Act was made. Similarly, forest policy in 1980, then revised in 1988. When anything become law, if anyone violate, then it becomes an offense and there are punishment for the same. Establishment of site. Site refers to Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species. It came into being on 1st July 1975. Countries of the world get together and they get success in protecting some endangered species. There is one paragraph given in your book that is enough for you regarding site. Celebration of Van Mahotsava, social forestry. We celebrate World Environment Day recently on 5th June. We have celebrated our few activities which help in conserving natural vegetation and wildlife. I hope the chapter is clear to all of you. Thank you. Have a nice day.